We are discussing about the solutions for GATE 2008 ECE paper, and the topic we are discussing is electron devices. And this is third question in the series of 1 mark questions. In the following limiter circuit, an input voltage VI is 10 sin 100 pi t is applied. Assume that the diode drop is 0.7 volts when it is forward biased. And the Zener breakdown voltage is 6.8 volts. The maximum and minimum values of output voltage respectively are A. 6.1 volts and 0.7 volts, B. 0.7 volts and minus 7.5 volts, C. 7.5 volts and minus 0.7 volts, D. 7.5 volts and minus 7.5 volts. You are going to calculate maximum and minimum output voltage ranges. Look at the circuit diagram clearly, and here given as Zener breakdown voltage as 6.8 volts, and whenever the diode is under forward bias, it is giving the 0.7 volts. And input voltage is given as 10 sin pi t. The correct answer for this question is C. Positive maximum is 7.5 volts and negative maximum is minus 0.7 volts. We will see the details of this problem. Before going to see the details, first we will see how a Zener diode is going to be acting. This is a symbol for Zener diode. This is P side and it is N side. This symbol represents looks like Z, that implies nothing but Zener diode. So these are the characteristics of Zener diode. VI characteristics of Zener diode: under forward bias, Zener diode is going to be looks like similar to the ordinary silicon diode. So even under forward bias, Zener diode also has a cut-in voltage as 0.7 volts. Zener diode generally treated as heavily doped silicon. So it also has a forward bias voltage as 0.7 volts. If you apply more than that 0.7 volts, at that time current flows, otherwise the current is approximately equal to zero. And whenever the voltage across Zener diode is negative, at that time there are two different regions are going to be appearing. One is reverse bias region based on the magnitude of reverse voltage. Look at this one. Under reverse bias, if the voltage reverse bias is nothing but V is negative, VZ is also negative. So if the voltage across the Zener diode is going to be greater than VZ and less than 0, that is nothing but this is the portion, second portion. During this portion, the Zener diode is under reverse bias and it acts as ordinary diode whenever it is in reverse bias. So under reverse bias, Zener diode also acts as open circuit and the current flowing through is 0 ideally. And third portion is this one. Whenever the voltage across Zener diode is greater than Zener breakdown voltage, Zener breakdown voltage is this one, as indicated in the diagram. This is Zener breakdown voltage. If you are applying more than this voltage for the Zener diode, at that time it comes into Zener breakdown region, where it is ideally maintains a constant voltage. Even though you are applying more than VZ, ideally it maintains constant voltage. That's why it is going to be used as constant voltage source wherever it requires in the applications. So the major applications are going to be voltage stabilization circuits and voltage regulator circuits. So this region is also going to be limited, and the region starts when the current flowing through Zener diode is IZ minimum, and the region is going to be stops when the Zener current flowing through it is IZ maximum. During that portion, it is going to be maintaining a constant voltage so that it can act as constant voltage source. Above this, if the current flowing through Zener diode is greater than IZ minimum, at that time the Zener diode will get breakdown. So now we'll see. Only one important thing is nothing but always Zener diode operates under reverse breakdown region, where it maintains constant voltage. The only check whether it is in reverse breakdown region or reverse bias. is nothing but you have to check the voltage across zener diode, whether it is going to be less than zener breakdown voltage or greater than zener breakdown voltage. If the voltage across zener diode is less than zener breakdown voltage, then it will be in reverse bias. If the voltage across zener diode is greater than zener breakdown voltage, at that time it will be in zener breakdown region and it maintains constant voltage as VZ. This is very useful, which is going to use to solve the problem. In our problem, input voltage is given as 10 sin omega t and you need to calculate the maximum positive voltage and maximum negative voltage. So for that one, maximum positive voltage you will get whenever you are applying input as positive, and maximum negative voltage will be getting whenever the input signal is minimum. So for 10 sin omega t, Vi minimum is minus 10 volts and Vi maximum is plus 10 volts. The maximum and minimum peak of sinusoidal is minus Vm and plus Vm. Here Vm is nothing but 10 volts. So first case, during positive half cycle, this is a given diagram. Look at this one. This is a given diagram. For this diagram, if you are applying positive voltage, Vi is positive. Vi is positive is nothing but this terminal is positive and this terminal is negative. Whenever you are applying positive voltage, by that time positive towards D1 P side. So diode D1 becomes forward bias and diode D2 becomes reverse bias. And whenever you are applying positive voltage for the zener diode N side, at that time it will come into reverse bias mode. But whenever you are applying positive maximum, how it will be behaving, that you have to check. Since we are interested in calculating the maximum output voltage, you must apply maximum input voltage. So we are applying Vi maximum as 10 volts. Now this plus 10 volts is applied to N side of zener diode. So N side of zener diode is going to be applied with plus 10 volts, that is greater than zener breakdown voltage, whose value is 6.8 volts. So the zener diode is under reverse breakdown region, where it maintains a constant voltage as 6.8 volts. And this D1 diode is under forward bias, so it maintains 0.7 volts across it as given. And D2 is reverse bias, which act as open circuit. So if you are replacing the diodes with equivalent circuits, at that time this is a circuit diagram results. Input voltage is maximum 10 volts and through resistor 1 kilo ohm, and zener diode is going to be having 6.8 volts constant voltage, and diode 1 is forward biased with 0.7 volts. So now the output voltage V0 is going to be 6.8 plus 0.7, that is 7.5 volts. So whenever V input is plus 10 volts, that is V input maximum is plus 10 volts, then output maximum what you are getting is 7.5 volts. Likewise, we will see during negative half cycle. During negative half cycle, all the voltages of sinusoidal signal are negative. Whenever you are applying negative voltages for the given circuit diagram, this is a given circuit diagram. For the given circuit diagram, diode 1 is reverse bias, diode 2 is forward bias, and zener diode is under forward bias, because negative voltage you are applying for the N side of zener diode, so that zener diode also under forward bias. So replace the diode symbols in the given diagram with equivalent voltages. So diode 1 is reverse bias, so it is acting as open circuit, and zener diode is under forward bias, so that it is going with 0.7 volts cut-in voltage, as which is equal to silicon cut-in voltage. So minus plus, the polarities, P side is positive, N side is negative. And diode 2 is going to be forward bias, so that it is indicated with P side positive, N side negative. So now V0 can be calculated from this point to this point, voltage drop across these two terminals, which is nothing but minus 0.7 volts. So V0 minimum, whenever you are applying minimum voltage minus 10 volts, at that time it is minus 0.7 volts. The output minimum voltage whenever V input is 10 sin omega t is minus 0.7. So that the maximum and minimum values of V0 are 7.5 volts and minus 0.7 volts. For the given circuit, the correct answer is C, 7.5 volts, minus 0.7 volts. Thank you.